Have you ever considered how crucial operating within legal and ethical frameworks is in public health? Picture this: every action, every decision, every policy implemented in the public health sector is guided by a set of ethical imperatives. These aren't just arbitrary rules, they're the backbone of public health practice, ensuring that our actions serve the best interests of the community. Honesty and integrity aren't just desirable traits in public health, they're non-negotiable. They are the compass that guides professionals in navigating the complex terrain of public health. From working in partnership with communities, recognizing when to escalate issues, to representing the interests of the public, honesty and integrity are the constants. Ethical frameworks aren't just about doing what is legally right, they're about doing what is ethically justifiable, balancing the needs of individuals with the greater good of the community. Now that we understand the importance, let's delve into how these frameworks translate into practice. To truly grasp how these frameworks function, we need to examine a real-life scenario. Picture a public health worker stationed in a small community. Their role is not to dictate, but to partner with the local people, helping them understand and implement health policies and protocols. This isn't a one-way street, but a cooperative journey where the health worker learns about the community's unique needs and concerns. They act as a bridge connecting the community with the broader health system. When the community faces issues outside the worker's capability, they don't abandon their post. Instead, they escalate the situation, ensuring the community receives the support it requires. They continually represent the community's interests, managing expectations about what services are available and how they can be accessed. In all their actions, they operate with honesty and integrity, guided by ethical frameworks relevant to public health. Let's unpack this case study and see how these principles come to life. In our case study, we observe a public health worker navigating the complexities of introducing a new health policy. This process is far from straightforward, as it involves a delicate balance of understanding, communication, and action. The first step is engagement. The public health worker recognizes the importance of involving the community in the decision-making process. This isn't a one-sided conversation, it's a dialogue where both parties learn from each other. The worker listens to the community's concerns, their needs, and their perspectives, while also sharing insights about the proposed health policy. Next is respect. The public health worker understands that every community is unique and has its own set of values, traditions, and beliefs. Respecting these differences is crucial. It means acknowledging the community's autonomy and their right to make informed decisions about their health. This respect fosters trust, which is the bedrock of any successful partnership. The final step is collaboration. The public health worker doesn't just impose the policy, they work with the community to implement it. They may adjust the policy based on the community's feedback or find alternative solutions that cater to their specific needs. This collaborative approach ensures that the policy is not only effective, but also culturally appropriate and sustainable. Throughout this process, the public health worker keeps the community's best interests at heart. They advocate for the community when dealing with service providers, striving to ensure that the community gets the support it needs. However, they also manage expectations, clarifying what the service providers can and cannot do. this transparency helps to prevent misunderstandings and disappointment down the line. In essence, the partnership process is a dance. It's a dance of understanding, respect, and collaboration. It's a dance that acknowledges the community's autonomy and values their input. And it's a dance that strives to promote and protect the public's health and well-being. This is a clear example of how to work in partnership with people and groups. But what happens when things go beyond the scope of the role? Sometimes the support needs of people or communities can exceed the role's scope. What then? In public health work, there are going to be instances where the need for support in communities surpasses what our role can provide. In these moments, it's crucial not to let the situation stagnate or worsen. Recognizing when a situation is beyond our capacity is not a sign of weakness or failure. Instead, it showcases an understanding of our professional limitations and a dedication to ensuring the best care for those we serve. In particular, if a person is at risk, it becomes even more important to escalate the situation promptly. This might involve reaching out to other service providers, engaging higher authorities, or seeking additional resources. The key here is timeliness. Delaying could result in adverse outcomes, and in our line of work, that's something we strive to avoid. But what about the expectations of the people we serve? Often, communities have high hopes regarding service availability and access. It's our job to manage these expectations, to bridge the gap between what people want and what is realistically possible. This can be a challenging aspect of our work, but it's absolutely essential. Being transparent about what services can be offered and when helps build trust and understanding. It's about providing clear, accurate information so that individuals and communities can make informed decisions about their health. So we escalate when situations are beyond our scope, and we manage expectations about service availability and access. But while doing so, there is another dimension that we need to consider, the ethical aspect. How do we ensure that in escalating situations and managing expectations, we are still acting with honesty and integrity? Recognizing one's limits and managing expectations is crucial, but how do we ensure our actions remain ethical? As we move forward, we'll delve into the ethical frameworks and guidelines that guide our practice in public health. Ethical frameworks and guidance play a pivotal role in public health practice. They are the compasses that navigate professionals through the intricate terrain of ethical decisions, ensuring that their actions uphold the highest standards of integrity and responsibility. Let's step back for a moment and ponder on what we mean by ethical frameworks. These are essentially well thought out structures that provide a systematic approach to evaluating complex ethical issues. They offer a broad perspective, helping us balance the scales of justice, autonomy, beneficence, and non-maleficence in a way that respects the rights and dignity of all involved. When it comes to public health, these frameworks are instrumental. They guide us in the creation and implementation of policies, ensuring we work in partnership with communities rather than imposing decisions from a distance. They also help us recognize when the needs of individuals or communities extend beyond our role, prompting us to escalate matters in a timely manner, particularly when a person is at risk. Moreover, these frameworks assist us in representing the interests of individuals when liaising with service providers. They instill in us the need to manage expectations about service availability and access, ensuring that we deliver promises we can keep and avoid creating false hopes. A myriad of ethical frameworks and guidelines exist, each relevant to different aspects of public health practice. Some are general, providing overarching principles for ethical decision making. Others are more specific, tailored to address distinct public health issues such as infectious diseases, environmental health, or health promotion. It's important to note that these tools are not rigid rules set in stone. Rather, they are flexible and adaptable, designed to evolve with the changing landscape of public health. They encourage critical thinking and open dialogue, fostering a culture of ethical awareness and responsibility. In conclusion, ethical frameworks and guidelines are indispensable tools in public health practice. They not only guide professionals in making ethical decisions, but also foster a culture of transparency and accountability. With these tools, public health workers can ensure they act with honesty and integrity. Returning to our case study, let's examine the impact of these ethical practices. The public health worker, guided by a strong ethical compass and legal boundaries, has made significant strides within the community. Through their efforts, the community experienced a marked uplift in health outcomes and overall well-being. The worker's commitment to honesty and integrity fostered a sense of trust and respect between themselves and the community. This trust was not just a byproduct of their ethical conduct, it was the very foundation of their successful partnership. By recognizing when the needs of the people were beyond their scope, the public health worker was able to escalate these issues effectively. This led to the timely involvement of other professionals and services, ensuring no person was left at risk. This careful navigation between roles and resources is a testament to the workers' commitment to their duty and the people they serve. Moreover, the workers' ability to represent the community's interests while managing expectations about service availability and access was pivotal. It helped the community understand and navigate the complex landscape of health services. This transparency not only empowered the community, but also cultivated a sense of shared responsibility for health outcomes. The workers' application of ethical frameworks and guidelines was not just a requirement of their role. It was a fundamental tool in their mission to protect and promote the health and well-being of the community. By adhering to these guidelines, the worker ensured their actions were not only effective, but also just and equitable. In essence, the public health worker's ethical practice transformed the community. It improved health outcomes, fostered trust, facilitated effective use of resources, and empowered the community. It's clear that the principles of honesty, integrity, and ethical practice are not just theoretical concepts. They are practical tools that, when used effectively, can drive real positive change. This case study shows the powerful impact of ethical and legal frameworks in action. As we draw to a close, it's crucial to remember the key points from our discussion. Firstly, let's remind ourselves of the ethical imperative in public health. It's about more than just doing what's legally required. It's about doing what's right. It's about acting with honesty and integrity and always keeping the welfare of the public at the forefront of our actions. In this field, our actions have far-reaching effects, and it's important to always keep our moral compass pointed in the right direction. Secondly, we examined the importance of working in partnership. We're not lone wolves in the field of public health. We're part of a wider network of individuals and groups, all working towards the same goal. We must work in collaboration with these partners, respecting their expertise and their perspectives, and incorporating their input into our policies and protocols. This partnership approach not only makes our work more effective, but also fosters a sense of community and shared responsibility. Then we delved into the process of partnership. We discussed how it's not enough to simply involve partners in our work. We must actively engage with them, listen to their concerns and ideas, and work together to find solutions. This requires a combination of empathy, communication skills, and adaptability. Next, we tackled the sometimes challenging topic of escalating and managing expectations. We all want to do the best for the people we serve, but sometimes their needs go beyond the scope of our role. In these situations, it's crucial to recognize our limitations and escalate the situation to those who can provide the necessary support. We must also manage expectations regarding service availability and access, ensuring that people understand what we can and cannot provide. We also explored the value of ethical frameworks and guidelines. These are not just theoretical constructs, they're practical tools that guide us in our work. They help us navigate complex situations, make difficult decisions, and uphold the highest standards of ethical practice. By identifying and applying these frameworks and guidelines, we can ensure that our practice is not only legal, but also ethical. Lastly, we reflected on the impact of ethical practice. It's not just about avoiding negative consequences or meeting compliance requirements. It's about making a positive difference in the lives of the people we serve by operating within legal and ethical frameworks. We can help promote and protect public health and well-being and contribute to a healthier and happier society. Remember, operating within legal and ethical frameworks is not just about compliance, but about ensuring the promotion and protection of public health and well-being.